Hi guys, coming to you from Fast Lane Classic Cars in St. Charles, Missouri.
And I thought you'd like a look at this 1970 Plymouth Road Runner Superbird. And you just don't see very many of these, that's for sure. If you're familiar with this car, then you know they made this for NASCAR racing. And obviously they extended the nose out so it would cut through the wind more efficiently. And they also added the rear wing back there that could be adjusted for downforce when necessary. And there's lots of little aero tricks on this car that make it cut through the wind. And it ended up with a very low coefficient of drag. Nowadays they build some of the modern sports cars to have a little downforce, so they stick to the road. This one was made mostly just to cut through the wind as efficiently as possible, and it did that just fine. You can see there's your Roadrunner Superbird decals, and under the hood here we have the 440 six pack, and you can see it says Coyote Duster on there. Very cool. I mean, it's got the factory exhaust manifolds, even the older style battery, everything. Just completely correct. And that is a numbers matching powertrain in this car. Very cool. And this is one of the little things that even when they extended this nose out ahead of the radiator support, they put a filler panel in there as well. And that helped to direct the air into there the way that they wanted. Lots of little things that you wouldn't notice at first. You can see it's got the factory rally wheels, just like it should have, very sharp. And the hood has the hood pins, of course. Very nice. And they have a complete storyboard on the car that tells you about some of the history of the Roadrunner Superbird. And they ended up, they only made this for the 1 year, 1970. And only 1920 were built. So that makes it a very rare car, obviously. This particular one has the black vinyl top, and you can see that's like brand new. Very cool. And on the inside here, you can see the seats are just like brand new. Nice set of buckets up front. And there's your beep beep horn there. And everything's pretty standard. You know, dashboard for that time. You'd see the same thing in like the Dodge Chargers and the other Roadrunners and things. But you have the 150 mile an hour speedometer there. And then over here it has the, you know, tick-tock clock or tack that they had. So you have the tachometer on the outer ring there and then a clock in the middle. Pretty cool. Just looks really nice. It's like brand new inside, obviously. There's your little under vents. And you can see the big Plymouth decal down the side. And then here's the famous wing out back with the Roadrunner decals. Very cool. And you can actually even vary the pitch on this upper panel here to get a little more downforce if you want to, I believe. And the trunk's trimmed out just like it would have been from the factory as well. Very sharp. This car's slick all the way around. Very long, obviously. But that's what was required to get it to cut through the wind the way they wanted. And inside here you'll notice it has the famous pistol grip shifter, the Hurst shifter. It's hooked to the 4-speed transmission. Very nice. Obviously very desirable. Very cool. Here, we'll go ahead and take a look at the specs on the car here. Sorry about the glare. All numbers matching. Got the 354 sure grip out back. Very cool. Anyway, guys, I knew you'd be interested in that one. So, I'm going to keep looking around and see what else they have. And I appreciate you watching and commenting and everything. And thanks again. See you later. Bye.